Matthew chapter 18 and 11. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. How think ye, if a man have 100 sheep, and one of them be gone astray, do he not leave the 99, and go off into the mountains, and seek if that which is gone astray? And if so be that he find it, verily I say unto you, he rejoiceth more of that sheep than of the 99 which went not astray. All right, I want to give all praises to Yahawah, BaHaSham, Yahawashi, BaHaSham, Rawchaa, Qadash. I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect scattered abroad, teaching his word of sincerity and truth. Shalom. All right, I'm the brother Taz of War with another quick hit, straight to the point. And this one is in Matthew 18, starting at 11. You know, the point of this lesson is, for the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. Now, what was lost was the Israelites. All right, so let me get a quick precept. This is Matthew 10 and verse 5. It says, well, I read verse 5. It says, these 12 Yahawashi sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. All right, and as ye go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. All right, so who is the lost in which the Lord is come to save? For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. When we read Matthew 10 and 5, 10 and 6, go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So now today you have these government churches and their doctrine, that, you know, doctrine of that they've been saved already. You know, the question is, what have you been saved from? Vocab, what have you been saved from? All right. If you've been saved, then you must be in your kingdom. And if that's the case, then, you know, you must share the blessing with Esau then. All right. Because our Lord, here in Matthew 18 and 11, it says, for the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. Now, who was lost? When we read Matthew 10, get straight to the point. Verse 6, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Okay, so the house of Israel was lost. All right. Matter of fact. Okay, now why we were lost? Why did we go, you know, get lost? Because we sinned against our Heavenly Father. Now this is Jeremiah chapter 17 and 4. And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee. All right. And I will cause thee to serve thou enemies in a land which thou knowest not, for ye have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever. All right, now ever just means a time, okay? Okay, an age. So, who did the Lord come to save? Matthew 10 and 6, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, because the whole house of Israel have been lost. The whole house of Israel have became strangers to Yahawah, BaHaSham, Yahawashi. But the best part is that we've been found, okay? In 2020, we've been found. And there's a great awakening, all right? The Israelites have woken up, and let me say in particular, the elect, all right? So let me read this again. This is Matthew 18 and 11. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. All right, what was lost? Matthew 10 and 6. But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. All right, now let me get Jeremiah 17 and 4. And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thy enemies in the land which thou knowest not. And that land here is what you call America. Okay. It says, For ye have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever. All right, which shall burn forever, which is a time. Now, let me get this scripture. Baruch chapter 4 and 5. It says, be of good cheer, my people, the memorial of Israel. All right, memorial. Okay, remembrance. The Israelites, the lost sheep of the house of Israel. It says, be of good cheer, my people, the memorial of Israel. Ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, not for your destruction, but because ye moved the Most High to wrath, ye were delivered unto the enemies. All right, so when we go back and we read Jeremiah 17 and 4, and thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thy enemies in a land which thou knowest not. For ye have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever. All right, which means the age, the time. All right, so when we go here to Baruch 4 and 5, it says, be of good cheer, my people, the memorial of Israel. Ye were sold to the nations, and we were, okay, the so-called blacks and Latinos. All right, we were sold to these Edomites and heathens. It says, not for your destruction, okay, not that we would completely be done and away with, that the Lord would never deal with us again. It says, but because ye moved the Most High to wrath, ye were delivered unto the enemies. All right, because, you know, when we sin, we go off, the Most High correct us by putting us in captivity. And ultimately, we've been in captivity under the Lord's sword, which is Esau, Edom. It says, for ye provoked him. Key word there is provoke. All right, by worshiping false gods. All right, different idols, things of that nature. It says, for ye provoked him that made you by sacrificing unto devils and not to the Most High. It says, ye have forgotten the everlasting power that brought you up, and ye have grieved Jerusalem that nursed you. It says, for when she saw the wrath of the Most High coming upon you, she said, hearken, O ye that dwell about Zion. The Most High have brought upon me great mourning, for I saw the captivity of my sons and daughters, which the everlasting brought upon them. With joy did I nourish them, but sent them away with weeping and mourning. Let no man rejoice over me, a widow, and forsaken of many, who for the sins of my children, of my sons, really, am left desolate, because they departed from the law of the Most High. So this is why we went into slavery. Okay, this is why we are being found by Yahawashi, BaHaSham, Yahawashi. Okay, let me just go quick reminder, read the scripture again. This is Matthew 18 and 11. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. All right, and right now we've been lost and scattered and dispersed through the four corners of the world. And the elect of the Lord, we like to call it the hopeful elect, is crying out. Okay, and the Lord is sealing these elect. Okay, starting with the men, all right, the prophets, man. So let's get back here. Baruch 4 and 12, let no man rejoice over me, a widow, and forsaken of many, who for the sins of my sons, all right, the children are supposed to be sons, it says, am left desolate because they depart from the law of the Most High. So this is why we went into ultimate captivity. And this is our last captivity, man, all right? This is the last time, according to 2nd Esdras 6 chapter with Esdras. Okay, he said, when Esau fall, Jacob is up next that follow. So this is why, how we know that we're up next, when Esau loses his power. It says, they knew not his statutes, nor walked in his ways of his commandments. And still to this day, the masses of the Israelites, which the world calls the black and Latinos, okay, West Indians, Haitians, Native and Seminole Indians, Mexicans, and so on, all right, the masses, the two-thirds, all right, of the Lord's people today, still to this day, do not walk in his statutes, do not walk in his ways of his commandments, nor tried in the paths of discipline and his righteousness. Because, you know, one thing about being in this truth, the first thing you learn is discipline. That's what you call a disciple. You know, a disciple is a discipline. Okay, he's disciplined in what? The word. All right. It says, let them not dwell about Zion. Come and remember ye the captivity of my sons and daughters, which the everlasting had brought upon them. For he have brought a nation upon them from far, a shameless nation, and a strength of a strange language, who neither reverence old men nor pity child. Okay, and that's these Edomites. All right, they're a shameless nation. Okay, just look at his history, man. From the Caucasus Mountains, all right, being a cavemen, you know. Just look at his whole track record. Just look at his mentality, all right. Look at his kingdom today. Look how it's dressed, all right. I ain't got to go into details. You know what it looked like here. It says, and a strange language, who neither reverence old men nor pity child. These have carried away the dear beloved children of the widow, and left her that was alone, desolate, without daughters. But what can I help you? For he that brought these plagues upon you will deliver you from the hands of your enemies. All right, so the Most High that brought these plagues upon us is the one that's going to deliver us from the hand of our enemies, man. Go your way, O ye children, go your way, for I am less desolate. I have put off the clothing of peace and put upon me the sackcloth of... Let me read this again. I have put off the clothing of peace and put upon me the sackcloth of my prayer. I will cry unto the everlasting in my days. And that's the point, okay? We're supposed to be crying out to the Lord, all right? You hear that vocab? We're the Hebrew Israelites, man, all right? And the Lord is going to save that which was lost. And what was lost is our inheritance, us as a people on the whole, okay? Us, the name of the Lord was lost at a time, but it's been found. It's been given to us again, okay? It says, for the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. How think ye, if a man have 100 sheep, and one of them be gone astray, do he not leave the 99, and go off into the mountains, and seeketh that which is gone astray? And if so be that he find it, verily I say unto you, he rejoiceth more of that sheep than the 99 which went not astray. All right, so the Lord is coming to save that which was lost. All right, and that's the Hebrew Israelites, not the black Hebrew Israelites, but the Hebrew Israelites. All right, Esau, Edom, okay, starting with these Rothschilds, they don't want us to have our nationality back. Matter of fact, I'm going to leave here with one scripture. I'm going to leave here with this scripture. They don't want us to have our nationality back because they're doomed. All right, they're doomed. This is Psalms 83 and 1. Keep not silence, O Yahawah. Hold not thou peace, and be not still, O Yahawah. For lo, thy enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. It says, they have taken crafty counsel against thy people, and that is us, and consulted against thy hidden ones, which is the elect of the Lord. It says, they have said, come, and let us cut them off from being a nation. You see that? All right. Esau, Edom, okay, who's ruling the world right now, wants to cut us off. Not only him, but the rest of the nations, as it's going to get into it, they want to cut us off from being what? A nation. And what is that nation? YASHARAHLA, all right? The Hebrew Israelites, okay? It says, they have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel be no more in remembrance, all right? It says, for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee, the tabernacles of Edom, and of the Ishmaelites, of Moab, and of Hugarians, Gabal, and Ammon, and Amalek, and the Philistines, with the inhabitants of Tyre. Ashur also is joined with them. They have hopped in the children of Lot, Shelah. All right. So, you know, there you go, man. So I hope this lesson was edifying. You know, the point is that the Lord come to save that which was lost. All right. Which are the elect of the Israelites today in 2020. All right, so with that, I want to give all praises to Yahawah, BaHaSham, Yahawashi, BaHaSham, Rawchaa, Qadash. I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to the Lord's elect. Shalom.